MW, you want to take the first one? Okay. So we'll go MW. Anime, you take second question. Brendan, third.
Chris,
four. Chris, five. And then after that, hopefully, Jake will be ready. Okay.
The other one.
All right, cool. Let's rock.
And roll.
Ruan, sorry about that. We were all a little bit disappointed. Where do you think it went wrong for you guys? Where did it really go wrong?
Yeah, I know. Obviously, it's definitely a tough one to take. So it's definitely going to hurt for a few weeks to come now. But yeah, like I said, in the post-match also, you got to give credit to the Warriors. I think that last try, that try just before halftime, maybe gave them a little bit of momentum and belief. I think we slipped up a bit there, one or two slipped tackles. So I think that was a big change in the game, was that 40 after the try they scored. And then definitely when they came out the second half, they put us under a lot of pressure with the box kicks. And I think they got some rewards from that. So, yeah.
Hello,
Ruan.
They say hindsight is perfect science. So if you look back at the game, do you believe that you played the perfect game plan, or would you now reflect on it otherwise?
Yeah, it's you can also always say what if, and what if you did this, and what if you did that. At the end of the day, that's the game is over. We had a plan. I don't think our plan was much different. We didn't want to go too different than last week against Leinster. I think obviously Billy was a big loss for us, especially in the kicking game. I think obviously Devin is an awesome player, but we definitely miss Billy's experience and just his kicking game. Definitely something I think we missed tonight. But yeah. Set piece wise, I think we wanted to put them under more pressure, and we didn't. Especially for Morling, we just didn't get the reward we wanted there. And again, credit to Warriors for stopping our mole. That's definitely a thing in our game that we want to create momentum from, and give our backs opportunities to play.
Ruan, hard luck, man, first of all. How do you, as personally in your personal life, go after second defeat in 3 years? How do you go and reflect on this, and how do you come back in a month or two stronger, if I can put it that way?
Yeah, it's a very good question, man. For me, I see this all as just the grace of God for giving me opportunity to play here. And it just wasn't meant to be. I think that first half, the World Coast try, nobody really know if it was held up or was it not held up. A lot of our guys saw it's left to try. So Devin breaking through, just not getting the pass to Kirtley. We offloading, and then at when they pass out of the back and the ball bounce and we kick it through, and Embro just couldn't get it away. So that's the small margins, and yeah, it's I don't really have words. It's definitely a tough one to lose two times in the final, and I'll just luckily I have a wonderful family and a wonderful wife that will definitely help make it through this next week. But yeah, we'll definitely come back stronger. That's the biggest thing we can do.
Just also another one. You scored 80 tries this season. You guys were the broke record scoring tries. Tonight there was only one try. As you said, with small margins, a couple of them could have gone your way. But it also says a lot about Glasgow's defence and how good they were at stopping your attack as well.
100%. I think the big thing was physicality. I think we got some rude ascendancy that first, say, 25, 30 minutes. I felt like we were really in a good space, front foot. We fronted up. They had a lot of opportunity attacking-wise in our 22, and we turned it over, and that gave us a lot of energy. And that's where you gotta keep teams there. You gotta cut them there. And like I said just now, that I think that last try, that try just at the end of first half, definitely switched some momentum in the game.
Ruan, it was tough on this one here, but if you look at stats don't win games, but the Bulls were up and down the pitch, I think 500-plus meters in this game, quite a bit of territory gain, but they seemed to shut you down when they needed to each time. Was there something through defense that surprised you at all, or it just didn't go your way?
Yeah, I know. Like, Brandon, I think they were very good defensively, and you got to give them credit. Defense at the end of the day wins you championships, and that last Mall stop we saw last year, Munster stopping also Mall stop at the end of the game. I can just give them credit.
Ron, you mentioned they stop your Malls. There's also always saying that in finals or playoff games you have to take your points if it's there. On hindsight, do you think maybe you should have gone for Poles for a few times, and then maybe in that last 2 minutes you could have won the game on with a penalty to the Poles?
Yeah, 100%. I think we got a when they scored that try. I think it was 66 minutes, and it was overturned, and we got that penalty on the halfway. I think, and obviously for me, it was I think it's 14 minutes left. Probably should go for balls, but yeah, I like to get the feel of the guys around me, and then not just make this decision on my own. And at the end of the day, I think it was a collective decision to go for touch, and then put them under pressure and keep them there. And we know if we could score a try there, we up with the lead. But yeah, looking back, taking the 3-20, 21-19. It's definitely it's a lesson learned for me. I've experienced it in previous games. I think last season in Scarlet's game also, I've been in the same position, take the points. But yeah, I can say a lot of different things now why I didn't take it. But yeah, it's definitely a thing I'm gonna think about a lot, and it's probably going to hold me a bit, but yeah, the game is over.
Cool. Thank you, guys.